Welcome back. The markets are once again losing a bit of steam, and the Nifty Bank in particular is impacted. It's down over a percent, 300 points down on that index, while the mid-caps are also showing weakness. Nifty is not that bad. It's at least not touching the morning low of 11,260, 265 thereabouts. Still short of that, but let's see. A second round of selling has certainly come in the Nifty Bank and the mid-caps. We're speaking with another mid-cap company. IndiaMART Intermesh has become the first B2B marketplace in India to register 10 crore users on the platform. The user base has jumped 10 times in the last 6 years. Dinesh Agarwal, founder of and managing director of IndiaMART Intermesh, joins us now. Good morning, Dinesh. Thank you very much. My first question is not really related to your growth, your secular growth, but more coronavirus related. There are people who are talking about stocking. So are you seeing increased transactions or the other way around post the last 10 days of coronavirus news?
So from the last couple of weeks or so, multiple categories are seeing huge demand coming, especially in the medical and mask and some medicine kind of categories. We are seeing a huge demand, but most of the demand goes unfulfilled because the supplies are not ready. The interesting trend is slightly broader based, where now people have started to look for replacement component or replacement intermediate items which they require in order to complete the overall business. So I think it is early days. We only have anecdotal responses and anecdotal questions, but I don't think we have any statistical to prove whether it is helping us more or going to be damaging more for India.
Okay, so maybe you'll find out in a few months from now, so we'll touch base with you once again. But what a phenomenal move your stock has seen. I mean, you've created so much wealth for investors over the last 12 months. I wanted to ask you a little bit about your 10 crore user base on your platform. How many are paying members, and at what rate is your membership growing? And you know, what would that have an impact on in terms of your earnings, your revenues, etc.?
So these are registered buyer numbers or registered buyers who have sent any inquiries on IndiaMART platform. So they have been growing pretty healthy rate. They were growing much more faster in the 2017-18, but even in 19-20 they have been growing healthier. In the last 25 months, I remember we were at 50 million users, and now we are 100 million users. So in 25 months we doubled up. That simply says that IndiaMART touches the lives of many more people than we think a B2B portal can do. In terms of paying subscriber, paying subscribers are out of the supplier base that we have, and we have about 5.5 million suppliers which are free, and 1,42,000 suppliers which are paying customers as of now, and they are growing at the rate of about 15-17% per annum.
Okay. What's the free cash you have? And I am asking you to include what you may have invested in mutual funds, etc., the amount.
As of this December 30th, we had about 850 odd crores of total free cash. And we had made one investment from IndiaMART, which was in Vyapar app, which is a mobile-based self-accounting app for business users, not for accountants. I'm very happy to share that yesterday only we have approved our first ever maiden dividend of 100% from IndiaMART. So after 20 years, we have declared first dividend yesterday.
And what are you planning to do with this 850 crore, any capex?
I think there are three uses that are possible. One, as I said, we gave some dividend. Two, we have invested in a company called Vyapar. We will continue to look for similar companies in the SaaS space or in the fintech space or in the e-commerce space. We love the SME, fintech, SaaS and e-commerce space. Mobile is definitely giving a lot of impetus to the entire ecosystem. Imagine if we had 50 million desktop computers, what they have done in the last 25 years.
Okay.
Now we have 500 million mobile computers. They can do a lot more in coming years. So I think we'll continue to invest in that side. Also, we have a deferred revenue on our balance sheet, which is about 650 crores.
Oh.
So we need to keep cash, and then we need to keep reserves.
Okay, fair point. Thank you very much, Dinesh, for joining us with your plans and the position of your company. Many congratulations for enriching so many investors. At the moment, though, some impoverishment of investors is what you're seeing with the Nifty Bank and the mid-caps continuing to be under pressure. Nifty holding head above water in the sense that it's not yet touching the morning low. But you would want to take a look at the rupee. It's weaker than where it finished yesterday, so that may be a harbinger of how things might move. We'll wrap up on Bazaar. Chartbusters next.